Well, let's go ahead and do this then, man.
right.
He's
All
not going to
right.
be here, so we'll just reschedule with him, and hopefully we can get him in soon.
Do you want to go back to us for the intro?
Yeah, let's do start over like we're doing a whole thing. I mean, I'm still going to put all that stuff about your colonoscopy in there, so
Great, great,
that's going
great.
to be the
Yeah,
intro. I think it's
great.
we can't ever do enough ass talk
I
on this show.
mean,
So, yeah, so
anytime we
that
can talk about our colons, we're gonna jump on that.
heavy metal colon, man. You know?
Hey man, this is Trevor William Church of Haunt and Beastmaker, and you're watching Heavy Metal Horror. Thank you.
I am Montag, Master of Illusion. What goes up must come down, but not always.
Hey, this is Chop Top, and this is one outsider going to be listening to another. Stay heavy.
And Dreadful.
And you are watching and listening to Heavy,
Heavy
Metal.
Metal.
Oh, kitties, kitties, we are pivoting today. Our guest didn't show up, but that's okay. You know, he'll come back. Who wouldn't want to
Doing
be
a
here
little
with us? Yeah, pivoting. So we are going to be doing
juke move.
A live reaction to the new Night Demon album, Outsider. For those heavy metal horror fans, you know Night Demon because we talked with Jarvis Leatherby, a singer, bass player, and a really cool guy. We're hoping to bring him back for some Slugfest. Night Demon's on tour. They're kicking it all over the place. They're playing all over the world. So good for them. But this is their brand new album. Just came out like March 23rd, right? Something like that. 24th, somewhere in that area. This is last yeah. week. So yeah. This is fresh. This is about as relevant as we're ever going to be. So,
yeah, this is it. This is
yeah, man.
Relevance.
Like, by accident,
yeah,
we're relevant.
We've hit the ceiling. There's nowhere else to go.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to.
A bug landed on my monitor. It went right in your mouth.
Montag. Nice.
That was great.
That's fantastic. All right. So are we ready for Night Demon? Track one.
Night Demon, Outsider. Let's go.
There we go. Yeah, I like the color, the cover work. Yes, the colors are awesome. Looks like
nice
a very
deep
80s,
low green.
Yeah,
yeah,
something like from a 1980s, like VHS
totally.
Horror.
Oh, yeah.
I like the border too around the cover as well.
Yeah,
and this is the opening track called Prelude. By
Prelude.
The way.
Yeah.
Prelude.
I like the production. Bass is down. It's nice.
Very warm.
The keyboard in there.
Very 80s.
Synthesizer, definitely. I'm thinking shades of Stranger Things.
Oh, good call.
I was getting Rush vibes.
Orchestral. Definitely sounds soundtracky. Yeah. Yeah, I like it. That's nice.
Almost feels like we're leaning into a concept album. I don't know if this is or not.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know anything about the album.
Yeah.
It's that fresh.
Outside,
Oh, okay. Ooh. We're right into track two here.
Like that.
That's like a good 80s sound. That's just driving.
Kind of Halloween.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Based on the album cover, skulls and flames coming out.
Kind of looks like the cover of a Stephen King novel.
Yeah,
or early
King Diamond novel.
Early one.
Yep. I think this was the first single. The shadow realm can never be your home. You shouldn't linger here and die alone.
This could almost be a Nightmare on Elm Street soundtrack song.
Mm-hmm.
I love the 80s-ness of it.
Yes, the 80s vibe is awesome.
It's great.
It fits with the cover.
Totally.
Yeah, I know. Even as part of that new wave of traditional heavy metal.
Yeah.
And we definitely borrow from those 80s sensibilities, and I think it works so well. But it's not like they're trying to imitate it. They're just like that style of music and doing their own version.
We had a nice production on that so far, too. Every instrument really comes to mind.
Yeah, it sounded good.
Nice. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh man, that's awesome.
Like Don't Talk to Strangers.
Yeah.
The baseline. Progression. Yeah. Chord progression.
Yeah. At times I'm getting like some Ozzy vibes.
Yeah.
That's great. Little Scorpions there.
Your backing vocals.
You want to pause after this and
yeah.
Man.
Ooh, all right, track one.
I feel like I'm transported back to my bedroom.
In my box teens. Of Kleenex at your side, Conan book in your hand, sticky pages. Oh, that wench on page 72. Ah,
not that particular memory.
Oh, okay.
A different.
And it was good housekeeping. It wasn't like,
that's right.
Okay. Oh, Sears catalog.
Yeah. Oh, spring issue. Yeah, when the swimsuits come out.
Yeah. No, like just the album in your hands. You know, laying in mm-hmm. front of the speakers right. in your bedroom, just looking at the artwork. You know, this is so 80s, man. It's mm-hmm. awesome.
Yes.
Yeah, I felt the same nostalgia you felt, Dredd. It does make you feel like back in that day when you're right in there and you got the CD, or I should say at that time, cassette. You're going through everything and just listening, chilling through the whole thing. And it brings back all those good memories of times like that. So, yeah.
Yeah, this is like the most nostalgic feeling I've had listening to some of these, like the new wave of traditional heavy metal, right. Like wow. I mean, there were moments of like Ozzy, like Ultimate Sin type feel to it. It's like Scorpions, yeah. some Halloween, like all the great stuff, man. It's
even right. that slowed it's down a, part was like a doom metal.
Yeah, that was really nice. Yeah. It was a nice surprise in the middle of that because I like the pacing of it as well. And it's not so heavy that this could be on the radio today, like radio friendly, on a hard rock station. This would fit in
absolutely.
You know, and that's not a slam to the music. It's not saying it's not metal because I mean we like Nightdeem.
Yeah, I think we're all loving this.
Yeah, no, this is fantastic, and I agree. It's the vibe is right there. The 1980s, and this is the soundtrack that we would totally be into. So, yeah,
100%. All right, making some go? Dungeons and Dragons adventures. Yeah. Listening to this, you know,
20, I killed a dragon. All right,
playing D&D in the basement.
You got that cover with the list
with Nightdeem going. With
that dude, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's an awesome cover. The first thing I noticed was the green, you know, the green and the yellow, yeah, that totally. Shade. I'm like, oh, that just pops right out of there, you know. Yeah, it's beautiful. Yeah, excellent. And the font, their demon or the night demon, the logo. I like that font as well. So, all right, let's get into track two, Obsidian.
Yeah.
Flash of the Blade by Maiden kind of thing.
Yes. Yes. Oh, nice.
Yep. Yes. The 1980s called. They're glad that 19 is making good music.
Man.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, this is such a... Oh, nice.
Still driving?
Yeah, I really like that riff.
I like those triplets. We need to see these guys when they come to Cleveland.
Yeah, this is going to be such a nostalgia hit.
They are. In April, they're coming to Pittsburgh, I think. There's no. Huh. I like the guitar line. All right. Yeah, there's twinges of that European metal are in all classic British. These guys are probably a little too young to remember that music first come out, like, you know?
Yeah.
Like, we're feeling nostalgia. Yeah.
Flash the Blade, baby.
Yeah.
Well, Jarvis is, I'm looking it up. Jarvis is 42, so yeah.
Oh, yeah. Considerably younger.
Tail end of it.
Yeah, that's right. That music was still prevalent when he was growing up.
Another slowed up second.
Nice wall pedal. My favorite wall pedal use, Dave Murray. Play a wah pedal like nobody else. I can see why these guys are getting big and like continuing to get up there. And the sound is just so good.
Yeah.
It's like straightforward and honest, no pretension, not overly produced. It's like three guys making music that sounds like three guys are making.
right, but I love the nod and tip of the hat to all these discussed about Halloween made hat things. Off sprinkles throughout. It's really nice.
Wow.
Whoa. Yeah, man. This okay. is just the stuff we love. You know,
like rotten, this, is, man.
This is what we grew up on. This is like food for our soul right here.
Yeah. Right? Like this is music we would be blasting in our cars. We're driving to the arcade. Yeah.
On those shitty stereo systems we had back in the 80s.
Yeah. You know? Going to go to Spencer's and look at some hot posters in the back room. Ooh, look at that.
The arcade.
Yeah. Playing some Dragon's Lair. Yeah. This is total D&D music. You know, absolutely. I mean, it is like we would be out in a tent in your backyard playing D&D in the summer.
Have this on a cassette with a boombox.
Yes.
Well, like we did live. Or just a little cassette player. Mm-hmm. You know. Some shitty little player of some sort. Yeah, but that's man.
Yeah.
This is so nostalgic.
Yeah,
the songs are tight.
I love that intro and the guitar. That's why I said Flash the Blade. It reminisced me to that. I was like, yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you talk about, again, they had another slow section in this song, Obsidian. It worked really nicely. The solo was really cool with the wah in there.
Yeah.
And very tight. Tight musicianship and songwriting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're writing like these, you know, 4-minute songs, and they're just cranking them out, you know. Yeah. So nice.
This is a fun little trip here, man.
Yeah, it's great. I knew a little bit what to expect because we know their music, but this album, I think, it's emblematic of who they are. But man, it is a good album. It may be one of their best. Mm-hmm. All right, shall we continue with Beyond the Grave?
A little 6 minutes here, over 6 minutes.
We're not going to get any Stonehenge tracks on this.
Nobody's falling asleep on the wind machine during this.
Yeah.
Where's my 20-sided die?
Right.
Yeah. Need to roll some dice here, man.
Yeah.
Fun tag.
Oh, your Pentel P205?
P205.
Nice. Is that V1?
V. The 205.
That thing's been 40 years old, man.
It is.
This is the shirt. I'm gonna go see them. This battle.
Oh, yeah.
That's the one I would.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Jumps off. Kind of like a dirge.
Yeah. Looks like a funeral kind of march kind of thing to it. Except you want to be taking that to your funeral, you know, you're already beyond the grave at that point.
At my funeral, I'm playing all my movies and all my music. So everyone has to sit through all my music, band music.
Talk about kicking us while we're down.
That's right. Get my revenge. Backing vocals too, was harmony. Yeah, it's really nice. Yeah, it's another thing you really don't hear a lot. Harmonies.
Mm-hmm.
That's very fantastic. That demon's run of the Ancient Mariner.
One by one, by the star dug into me.
Wow.
Oh, nice.
Solo.
Yeah. Really ripping it here.
Oh, I
wanted more of that.
I wanted more.
Yeah, I want more of that.
Yeah, I was like wanting the chorus to kick in and with that speeding up. Yeah, bring it.
Built up again to another one?
Yeah. I hope so.
That was the teaser.
Flashback.
Ain't it though?
This is like hitting us in all of our sweet spots.
I know. You know? I feel like I'm gonna get like teleported through time, you know?
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Wow. I like the bass right there.
You can hear everything really distinctly.
Yeah,
nice.
Real great bass.
Yeah. Next the song.
Wow. Nice.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah. It's a deep snare that he's playing. A little loose. The snares are a little loose. Get that sound. Not tight.
Wow. So that was 6:20. That went by fast.
Yes.
Wow, that was a really quick.
And it wasn't boring at all, right? We can all agree there was so much interesting stuff. And it, again, gives us all that nostalgic feeling like we talked about, brings back to our time period. So
you mentioned like it's just an honest, they're not trying to reinvent the wheel. This is just like it's just like great 80s inspired metal, you know.
Yep.
Man,
that was a great track. That was really
I was fully invested in the slower, dirgier track. It fits with the Beyond the Grave, you know. Like that's fine. I'm like, okay, cool. And then the break, and I'm like, oh, once it got to that fast, that faster tempo, I didn't want to go back to that. You know, I'm glad they did at the end. It was nice to finish at that slow,
yeah, a little bookend.
Yeah, I just wanted more solo, man.
More
cowbell there.
That
really left us wanting.
That second solo when it dropped, you're just like, no, I felt the same thing. I'm like, please go.
You teased me.
Damn it,
was fantastic. Fantastic stuff, guys. Jarvis. You guys are kicking ass, man. Nicely done. All right.
That might be my favorite track so far. We've always been kind of suckers for the longer tracks, too, you know.
We like the time changes, but, you know, I'm also, I mean, I like the simplicity and the drive of the first couple songs. They're just, like, straightforward.
Absolutely.
You know, just like, you know, it's like just rock and roll metal, you know, it's just hard rock. But they're showing a little bit now. They can do a few more things here. They're showing some nice stuff.
Pretty epic track. Yeah.
Okay. Rebirth. Here we go.
Dual leads there.
I think there's only one guitarist.
Okay.
Harmonizing. Even the picking style does. I mean, 1987 is called, you know? This is vintage.
Yeah. You could tell me you picked this up at Camelot Music.
Yeah. Yeah, I got this in the record club.
Yeah.
What was that record
club?
Columbia House.
Columbia House.
I got this for 99 cents.
Yeah, we would have played the shit out of this.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, we would have.
Unexpected. That's the thing. Yeah. Nice little things that are unexpected.
Little details. Really nice.
Right.
They keep you interested.
Yeah.
Halftime.
Definitely hear that kind of doomy influence.
Yeah.
Chord progressions aren't necessarily doomy. It's like tuned to like a regular tuning.
Yeah, that's the standard, I believe.
Happy, it's like a happy doom.
Yeah. Ooh.
Stank. That's a stank face.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Track. They crammed a lot into 3.5 minutes right
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Truly did.
Oh, that was a great song. Dude, these songs keep getting better.
Yeah. I'm really appreciating about this, we had talked about it, we're not used to seeing a 35 minute album. I mean, I haven't seen a 35 minute album probably since Rain and Blood. You know, like one thing we liked about Maiden's albums, they were always longer than normal, you know, average. Mm-hmm. But now when we have gone to CD, and now you don't even need to have physical media, we've seen albums that were like an hour, or with Dream Theater, 2 hour long discs, you know, and things like that. And sometimes bands, when they put out an album with 14 songs, it's an hour and 15 minutes. Sometimes that album kind of outstays its welcome, you know, like
it gets diluted a little bit.
Yeah. You get a little fatigued, like, okay. But with an album like this, 35 minutes, you don't have time to get fatigued.
It feels concise. Like every song feels tight and contained.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nothing's running on or dragging on. Like they've like boiled it down to its essence.
I think also talking about running lengths though, is that, you know, we live in a day and age where everybody has a shorter attention span. I know as I've grown older, my attention span seems to be waning, you know? So I appreciate it because you're putting all this in, but like you said, the tightness, the cohesiveness, throwing back to that 80s kind of feel really gives a nice warm nostalgic feeling. And yeah, man, they're pulling it off. Like, yeah, I could see why they're one of the more popular bands out there in this new wave.
Yeah, so. I totally would have loved to go see them. I'd love to see these guys live.
Yeah, this is outstanding. Yeah,
you know, yeah, yeah. As we can say with so many of the bands that we have interviewed and talked with, we just love their music, and these guys are no exception. And man,
and this seems to me the type of music that would sound fantastic live.
Yeah.
You know, like Maiden always sounds a little better live. Like a lot of these 80s sound, the 80s sound seems to get enhanced when you play it live. So, yeah, I'd love to hear these dudes live.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
In person.
Oh, nice. All right. So, the next track, Escape from Beyond. Not hearing anything.
Is it playing?
Yep.
Oh, there it is. Yep. Ooh, it's Judas Priest?
Yeah, right.
Free Will Burning?
Yeah. Defender Zero stuff?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Halloween, man, all over.
Yep.
I'm like fans like accept or something like that. You know, I'm hearing. Hearing a little bit of Accident of Birth in here too, right? That whole album sound.
Oh, some you know?
Yeah, Bruce Dickinson.
Yeah,
Roy Z there.
Yeah, totally right.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I love that guitar note line.
Yeah.
Oh. I love this chorus, man.
Do that galloping thing really nicely.
Yeah.
The solos are so good, I just want more of it.
Yeah, they're really good.
Like, come on, yeah.
Uh-huh.
But it fits, though. The songs are compact and concise. It was a 3-4 minutes.
Yeah.
It fits what it needs to do.
Except for the one time.
Yes.
We needed more.
Definitely.
That guitar melody is deep. Nice.
A Maiden ending.
Yeah, I was going to say, wait a minute. Yeah, it's Brand Major Painter. I was just going to
say.
Totally, that's great.
Wow. Brilliant.
Oh, damn, man. Another winner.
That's fantastic.
Wow.
You know, what's so great about this band, we talked about Touch the Run, just how they mix so many of their influences, but it's uniquely identifiably Night Demon, you know, because you get splashes of it throughout, and I agree. Those solos, you just like, keep going. Keep going.
Yeah. Yeah.
These are great. They're that good. So.
Yeah. Well, you're hearing their influences, but it, I mean, we recognize them because we have the same influences, the kind of music that we like, but it just reminiscent of that, but it's not that,
I have no problem with bands just wearing their influences on their sleeve. I mean, Dream Theater is unabashed about the bands they love. And, you know, mm-hmm. when they go into the studio, they'll have a stack of CDs from different bands that are going to inspire the album that they're getting ready to make. So they don't hide from it. You know, yeah. there's nothing wrong with it. Everybody's influenced by somebody.
Precisely.
It's not a dig on anybody to hear the influence.
Not at all. Music. And just because we've heard this music for so much of our lives, for the last 40 years, that we hear these influences, it's like, we recognize the sound or whatever the style, or it just makes us give us that little flash, briefest of flashes of something else, but it is uniquely original. And
I love that. I love that about it. I love getting that little moment of like, oh my God, I'm transported back, you know, like these little moments of nostalgia hits just.
Yeah.
Wow. So far, awesome. A fantastic release. Yeah.
Man, this is great.
So we got the next
more tracks
song
to go.
A Wake coming up. Jimi Hendrix. And the guitars are not overly distorted in any of the songs. It's like a perfect level of distortion that fits the style of music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
They're not pushing it.
Yeah. If they did push it, it would take it away from the 80s sound, you know? They're staying within that sound.
It just sounds like overdriven amps, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You can hear a beautiful tone. Scorpions.
Absolutely.
You
gotta have the ballad, man. It's not an 80s album without a ballad.
Older songs. Blackout?
Blackout, yeah, I was gonna say.
Yeah.
It was like a little bit before this, like I will be landing.
Oh, there was a solo he played.
Yeah,
to completion there.
Gave it
we
to
needed
it.
That and Beyond the Grave.
Yeah, he brought us to completion there.
Right.
Is that it?
One more, an epic.
Wow.
Tune.
Okay, that was the ending on the solo. Wow, this is a 7.5 minute track.
Yeah, interesting. Interesting end. I like that.
Yeah.
We got an epic closer here.
Yeah, and with that one, it was Scorpions vibes, and you had definitely, like we talked about, the Maiden-esque runs throughout the soloing and different, and it's like, wow, yeah, pretty complete. I like it.
Yeah, It's a good track. There's been no filler on this album.
None whatsoever. No.
No
chance to get bored.
We need another song to make it 38 minutes. No, right. No. We're going to give you 35 minutes of kick-ass rock and roll, and that's what we're getting.
Yep.
Yeah, this is just a fantastic album. This is going to be like regular rotation. You know?
Yeah, man, this is so good.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's just do this last one then, man. We are Escape. The Wrath. The Wrath. Here we are.
Looks like classical guitar.
Chord progressions are really interesting. Not what I'm expecting. And it's good. Yeah, it's so unique.
Yeah, they definitely managed to surprise you.
Yes.
Here we take
that. I love all the Maiden moments, man.
Oh, man, yeah.
Goosebumps.
Ooh, time change. This is the song you will play as loud as you can.
Yes. This might get me into a mosh pit. This song.
Yeah. You know they're gonna play this live.
Fucking
shred, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like. Oh. I'm hearing like shades of like Killers.
Yeah.
That album 16 again.
Yep. Yeah.
Now I got a chub.
Hell yeah.
Ooh,
I got goosebumps all over.
God damn.
Great solo.
Ah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I love the main sprinkle throughout this.
Get the bludgeon.
Oh, they're just riding it out now.
Yeah.
They know they're in the pocket.
Yes.
This is the way to end an album, man.
Uh-huh.
There it is.
Shades of an empty room.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. Letting us down easy.
Mm-hmm.
Coming down off our high.
Yep. They're taking good care of us.
Yeah.
That stood out to me.
This is the cuddle.
We're cuddling now.
This is the cuddling.
Getting spooned.
Look, we've had our way with you. Now we're just going to spoon.
Here's $10 for the cab. Get the fuck out of my bed.
I feel loved. I feel loved by this album.
You know, what I love throughout the whole album is how they have the leads, and then it's really rumbling going on, and then drops back into a slow part or a quiet part. These transitions that go very smoothly to very, tightly written passages of this. It's really amazing and present throughout the whole entire listening thing. Congratulations, Jarvis.
Bravo, great Night album. Demon. Holy moly.
Wow. What?
Dude, do I use the term masterpiece? My God, that was great from top to bottom.
Absolutely.
That was amazing.
You know, I want to do some more research. I wonder if that was a concept album, because the name of the titles alone, how it all kind of seemed to congeal together and everything was, it gave me that sense that it was a concept album. But maybe I'm wrong, but it just from the titles and the
it was definitely cohesive, it felt very cohesive throughout.
I'll have to look at the lyrics and read them through and see if that's the case. I was going to contact Jarvis anyway and have him, see if he wanted to come back and talk about the tour and maybe bring the rest of the guys on the, maybe do a slugfest or something with us. But I definitely will be sending them a link to this man alive. This is one of the best albums I've heard in a long time.
I thoroughly enjoyed that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't think I was expecting it. I mean, I'd heard snippets of the single, and like I said, I know there are their music, not as much as other bands, but this album is so good and so concise and tight and so well produced. It's just
one great moment to the next. It just carries you from one great moment to the next. It's just, every song has these great moments.
Thoughtfully arranged too. If it's not a concept album, the songs were arranged in such a way where you carry those moments in. It was beautifully orchestrated from beginning to end. This emotional kind of curve it took you on.
Yeah.
You really can't pick. I mean, you can't say what's your favorite track because the whole damn thing's smoking. But I think Escape from Beyond is so epic. Beyond the Gray was fantastic. Those are highlights for me. Outsider, the title track. That ending track, The Wrath, I believe, and stuff. I mean. You could just go ahead and throw a dart
in the dark at any of the songs and like, hell yeah.
Each new track, I'm like, oh, I think this is my new favorite track. And then the next one, oh, I think this is my favorite now.
And let's hear it for the guitar player, right? 19, what a talent. I mean, tremendous stuff there.
Yeah, all the different styles, the acoustic stuff. The
wine there.
Mm-hmm.
It's fantastic, top to bottom.
I can't think of a single criticism.
There wasn't a part that I'm like, oh, yeah. It wasn't predictable. It always took me someplace I didn't expect.
It wasn't boring.
It wasn't boring.
And there were always pleasant surprises. There were always pleasant surprises.
Right, from the chord progressions that they used to the melodies to the time changes. Mm-hmm. I thought the solos were really passionate. That one track, a little short, but we wanted more because it was so good.
It gives another 30 seconds on Beyond the Grave.
Yes. We finally got that payoff toward the end. But man alive, these guys know what they're doing. This is a fantastic record. Mm-hmm. And I think it's friendly enough for people who aren't into metal per se. Just if you're into hard rock, any of the bands that we like, that new wave of traditional heavy metal, if you are, you know, a fan of any of that kind of style of music, you are going to go gaga over this, and you are just going to go out and buy it.
This captures so much of what we love about 80s metal.
Don't think about it. Yeah. Buy it. Yeah.
Yeah. Seriously, go support them on tour. They're on tour right now. Buy their shirts, buy their music. Tell them Heavy Metal Horror sent you. And man, fantastic. Before we get on out of here, I want to thank Nikki Law Breaking the Law PR for sending us the record. And for letting us do a live reaction, this is fantastic. And Jarvis, man, you guys fucking knocked it out of the park. I am serious. We got to have you back.
Yeah. This is something to be really proud of. This is great stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I want that. I want the artwork. I want I want that LP size artwork, you know, and just put it on my wall, put it behind me.
Yeah.
You know, that's what I want. Yeah. Fantastic. Fantastic.
Another great listen. Yeah.
Oh, totally.
Yeah, we could go on and on, man.
Let's make it short about it. Just like the album. We don't want to overstay our welcome either.
We
typically do.
All day.
That's right.
Hey, no, they don't want to hear about our ailments anymore.
That's right. Just the old two fingers in the shooter. You can find Heavy Metal Horror on unsaneradio.com. Listen to full episodes or download to your device. You can find us on Facebook, Heavy Metal Horror Podcast. On Instagram, look for Montag Lewis, one word. Our YouTube page, Heavy Metal Horror Podcast. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. And if you know someone who'd like our show, tell them about us. This has been Montag, Master of Illusion.
Chop Top.
And Night Demon fan, Dreadbull.
You've been watching and listening to Heavy Metal
Night Demon. This is Doug Helvering, and you have been listening to Heavy Metal Horror, the best podcast that you've never heard before.